Outline the indications for central venous cannulation in neurosurgical patients. Briefly mention the two common techniques and their complications. Role of dexmedetomidine in neuroanesthesia practice. Discuss the cerebrospinal fluid dynamics. Briefly mention the effect of commonly used anesthetic drugs on CSF. Discuss the concept of cerebral autoregulation and carbon dioxide reactivity. Describe the intracranial pressure volume relationship. What is the rationale of hyperosmolar therapy in neuroanesthesia? Compare mannitol versus hypertonic saline. Elucidate the pharmacological effect of inhaled anesthetics on cerebral blood flow, metabolism, and autoregulation. Describe the mechanism of injury following cerebral ischemia. Briefly outline the strategies for cerebral protection. Enumerate the physiological changes in a pregnant patient and their clinical significance in patient undergoing neurosurgical procedure. Enumerate the various invasive techniques to measure intracranial pressure. Discuss the principle and application of cerebral oximetry, NIRS. Mention the limitations of NIRS. Discuss the anesthetic management of a 40-year-old patient with acromegaly scheduled for endoscopic transnasal transsphenoidal resection of pituitary adenoma. What are the indications for cerebrospinal fluid shunting? Discuss the perioperative anesthetic management of a 2-year-old child scheduled for ventriculoperitoneal shunt procedure. Discuss special anesthetic consideration of deep brain stimulation surgery. How will you diagnose venous air embolism intraoperatively during sitting position neurosurgical procedure? Discuss its management. Discuss the anesthetic consideration of a 6-month-old infant scheduled for stiff craniectomy for craniosynostosis. Describe the anesthetic consideration for awake craniotomy. Briefly mention the commonly used drugs. Pathophysiology and management of spinal shock. Anesthetic management of a 50-year-old male patient with controlled hypertension scheduled for clipping intracranial aneurysm. Anesthesia and sedation for neuroimaging procedures. Intensive care management of a patient with severe traumatic brain injury in neurosurgical intensive care unit. Describe the principles of neuroprotection. Discuss the various strategies for neuroprotection during neurosurgical procedures. Principles and protocols of enhanced recovery after surgery from neuroanesthetic anesthesia perspective. Enumerate the protocols for preoperative assessment and perioperative management of COVID-19 positive patient scheduled for emergency neurosurgical procedure. Principles of perioperative fluid and electrolyte therapy in neurosurgical patients. Concept and application of motor evocal potential monitoring. Principles and anesthesia consideration for endovascular approach to acute ischemic stroke. Principles and application of transcranial Doppler. Name the nerves involved and the procedure of skull block with the help of a neat diagram. Principle and utility of monitoring the depth of anesthesia. Management of a patient with Guillain-Barré syndrome in the intensive care unit.